Good afternoon. My name is Jim Conlan and welcome to the latest episode of our entertainment show. As you know, in part three of our entertainment show, we premiere a new TV series or movies that are debuting here in Ireland and the UK, and especially here in Ireland where Irish eyes are smiling. And for this week's episode, we're delighted to have an all-star guest, obviously, with us this evening to talk about what has been a phenomenal show, a phenomenal success, 10 seasons in total. But unfortunately, that journey has to come to an end at some time, and this is the final season of the smash hit. It took that 70s show. When we talk about that 70s show, when we talk about the 90s, we talk about series like Saved by the Bell, The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. But when we talk about the 80s, the 80s will be remembered as the Goldbergs, and an all-star cast in the Goldbergs, and we have the one and only Wendi McLendon Covey, Troy Gentile, Hayley Orrantia, Jeff Garlin, who was there for 9 seasons out of the 10. But the principal character based on the series was the one and only Adam Goldberg. The show was created about him. And for all of those seasons, Adam Goldberg was portrayed by the one and only Sean Giambrone. Sean joins us this evening here. Sean, an absolute pleasure. 10 years, Sean. Where did it go? And is it bittersweet to think that it's finally over?
Rich, thanks so much for having me, Jim. That was an awesome intro. I really appreciate that. And yeah, great question. It feels like it just went by. I was 13 when it started, and now I'm like a full-grown adult. It's crazy. I can't believe the journey we just had.
Yeah, and I suppose, Sean, when you started off with this project with the Goldbergs 10 years ago, yourself, Hayley, Troy, Wendi, Jeff, were you thinking to yourself, right, we might get a season one, and obviously then with a bit of success, we might get 2 or 3 seasons. Did you ever imagine in your wildest dreams that you would have 10 full years, 10 seasons? Was it that after, once you got past the third season, was it almost like every season was a bonus, everyone was a happy surprise, and oh, they've renewed us here for another season?
Yeah, it was kind of wild. I think the first season, I really wasn't grasping what was going on and how crazy it was to like do a pilot and then that pilot being picked up, and I kind of run nervous. So I was like, I was planning on playing soccer in high school and all this stuff. I was like, I don't think that's going to happen if this happens. And I was kind of like freaking out. I was like, what's going to happen? And it ended up being one of the most cherished memory of my life is working on this show. And I remember in the first episode, there one of the PA guys, he told me, you really should spend time with Wendi and Jeff and everyone, because it's a rare opportunity to work with these people and it might be the last time you work with them. And I remember I had this weird feeling. I was like, no, you know what? I did. I talked to him and I was like, I didn't feel like it was that fleeting of a moment. Like, you know, it was like a weird sense that it might keep going or something, but never any idea it would go 10 years. And every time we got picked up for another season, it was like, here we go. We get to do it again. It was really wonderful.
And Sean, in terms of, was it halfway through the airing of season one, maybe 6-7 episodes in, where you're thinking to yourself, hey, you know, we might have something here. This seems to be popular enough. Reaction seems to be going down well in terms of this. Hold on a second. This might actually take off.
Well, there was definitely people on set with a lot more experience than I had. And they were like, no, I think we have something captured here or whatever. And I just knew I was cracking up when they sent the pilot the first time and we got to watch it before it aired. And my brother's a hard sell. He was laughing. And I was like, so I thought we had something just because it was making me laugh. But yeah, there were that first season had some real like gem episodes that like, when we saw them, we're like, wow, we really put together some really fun things.
Yeah. And Sean, do you think maybe that you touched on an era in terms of the 80s that hadn't really been touched? The 70s had been touched. Maybe the 60s with Happy Days had been touched. We had all seen about that sort of 90s thing, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Saved by the Bell, Saved by the Bell, Sabrina, sort of teenage witch. But no one had sort of ventured into the 80s because it was the hippie sort of 70s. Then it was the teenage kids in the 90s. So no one had sort of ventured into that era. Do you think he found a niche there maybe that maybe someone hadn't really touched on in terms of that, that maybe people think, yeah, that was a real good representation of what the 80s was like?
Yeah, they're really, I think Adam and Doug, they, the producer and the creator, they kind of had, I think they saw it coming or something, because Adam is a huge fan of Transformers, Star Wars, all that stuff. And all that was coming back in cartoons and things. And I think it just timed out that they started and it was like the perfect window, because a little bit after then, Stranger Things came and a couple other shows that really strengthened the attention on the 80s, and we just happened to already been catching our stride a little bit, so then people kind of hopped on and to us to keep the 80s alive. So it was a really, really fortunate time to start the show. And yeah, and I know Adam was a really good person to spearhead it, because he was just obsessed with all of it, from the arcades to the movies and the music. So yeah, I think a lot of people were touching back to the 80s from all the cultural angles that he was bringing to our show.
Yeah. And Sam, what's it like, dare I say, having Wendi McLendon Covey as a sort of, a character upon a character for 10 seasons, and having her as your sort of mother? She almost must feel like a second mother to you at this sort of stage, and in terms of the role she's played in your life so far.
Oh, absolutely. She's one of the most incredible actresses, but then also just an incredible person. She like her heart is just there constantly. So any cast member, any crew member would always feel comfortable just walking up to her and just catching up, and she would spend the time. Like, she's amazing in that way. Also getting to watch her act and just try and learn from that was a lot of fun. But it really was the best job in the world, because every episode you get a hug. So it really, that kind of, like no other workplace, you really are just like get that many hugs. It was kind of just quite a thing. So you really strengthen that family bond. And so by the end of it, it almost feels like I've gone off to college now, because I'm not seeing my family as much now because the show ended. It's a wild thing.
Yeah. And obviously, before we touch on season 10, and that's what we're here, we're just sort of reconnaissance, I suppose, about the full sort of 9 seasons. And I suppose try Gentile's character, Barry sort of Goldberg, to be out there, to be as wacky and sort of quirky as the character was. Dare I say, is that a sort of a false representation in terms of real life? Because he seems like a very sort of level-headed guy. So had he to sort of take himself out of his own norm and really try and evolve his sort of character, take himself out of his comfort zone to play so out there, so dare I say, off the top?
Yeah, he, like, you totally got him from, like, when you're saying the level-headed thing like that. He's just the sweetest, like, he has this thing where he can remember anyone's birthday. But the first time he met my grandma, he found out what her birthday was. Like 5 months later, he saw her again. He's like, oh, your birthday's coming up. And it was like the next week or something. He's an extraordinary person. But when you also talk to him, he's the funniest. Like, I think if you talk to anybody on set, he probably would be the one that made everybody laugh the most, because he can just, the stuff he comes up with. So you can tell it's in him to have all this, like, this big personality that can fill out a character like Barry. But he's just really, in real life, he's this cool guy that's good at sports. He's good at rapping. He's kind of just good at a lot of things. And but what he came up with, Barry, and throughout the years, he kept growing to different areas. And it's like, wow, it's a fun character to watch.
Yeah, and we all know Hayley, a talented musician in her own right as well, a very talented singer. She was able to bring her sort of singing talents on the early seasons on set in terms of the Goldbergs as well. And obviously, she, as a double act, she's very much a a talented musician and talented actress, but she really delved deep into the Goldbergs, into the role, and maybe put that maybe as a prominent stage over some of her musician sort of work. So she really committed fully to the Goldbergs project, because she was very much an aspiring musician as well.
Correct. Yeah. She, everyone on set, it just like, I think that first season just cherished the experience so much that everyone kind of just doubled down and really focused, and we ended up being really proud of what we created. And I think, yeah, for her having such a strong passion, because I think her first passion is probably music, but she just happens to be an amazing actress and super funny. And that, yeah, I know throughout she's released some songs, but it has been kind of, but I know now, talking with her, she's recording stuff already. And then she's got a fiance now, and he does some music too. So I think in the near future, you're going to see a lot of music coming out from her. But yeah, it was cool during the show that there was able to be some interplay between the two. Cause did you see that Masked Singer thing that she was on? That show?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. It puts you to tears. It was like, yeah, that one Whitney Houston song or whatever. I was like, there's no one that could sing better than that. And I was like, I might be biased, but I almost put Haley's rendition top of all. So like, that was really amazing stuff.
Yeah. And Sean, obviously coming back for season 10, there was some sort of changes. We won't go into it. Jeff Garlin departed, obviously, Pops in terms of his own character in real life, sadly, departed the world as well. So in terms of that family dynamic, he had lost sort of two popular sort of figures for the full sort of that were witchy for nearly 9 seasons of the show. Was that sort of, dare I say, a challenge coming back for season 10 to be down two sort of cast members, dare I say, that probably carried a good bit of weight of the show? Had you all, as the remaining 4 prominent characters, yourself, Wendi, Troy, Haley, had you all had to maybe take on extra responsibility on your shoulders in terms of upping your game even more to make up for those losses?
Yeah, it's interesting because, yeah, when you watch the show back, I know, because it was the last season, I kind of got sentimental and I started watching some old seasons, and there's such a strong dynamic that each of those characters brought, that not having them there, it does change the show a bit. And I know, like, there's certain like combinations of characters, it's like, oh, it's hard to beat when it's this person and this person. So then when they're not there, it does change the show quite a bit. But we're lucky that a lot of our strength comes from our guest cast. And then with the final season having, or final couple seasons with Jeff Schwartz, with Sam Lerner being a series regular and things, there was kind of a new dynamic. And I like, it was kind of wild when I was like, throughout the run, there's almost been different eras of the show. Like the first couple years were like really sincere and more true to life. And then it kind of got bigger. And then there's different eras with different love interests and things. But I felt like at the end of this 10th season, there's kind of a cool breath going on. And I would have loved to seen it another year, but 10 years seemed kind of like a perfect end. But yeah, the writers were really creative and were able to capture some kind of new energy going on. And so I think it really worked out despite it being a different show than how we started out.
Yeah. And I suppose, Sean, in terms of season 10, obviously there are changes. Erica is expecting a child throughout the season. You're off to college, dare I say. You'll have a lovesick sort of mother who sort of lost her baby, dare I say, and now she's venturing into the dating sort of world again in terms of her next aspect of her life as well. So in terms of meshing those sort of dynamics in terms of the season 10, was it interesting and exciting, all the different changes that was happening on the show?
Yeah, it was definitely interesting. Every time we would get a new script, it was like, I wonder which direction we're going to go in. And, And then, of course, we always have those, the movie episodes where they're directly from. And I was curious, what are those going to be this year? Because we always have some of those. But it was pretty wonderful once the babies, because that just was, it turns out I'm not too good at holding babies yet. So I got to work on it. But that was, it was just a instant smile whenever they walked on set, because it was like the twin thing. There's two playing one. And yeah. It was an exciting year getting to hear some new kind of storylines.
And Sean, when you sort of see your character at season 10, and maybe you look back at him in sort of season 3 or season 4, in terms of seeing his evolution in terms of Adam Goldberg, are you happy where he wound up in terms of his character, in terms of the final finish article, dare I say, heading out into the big bad world, in terms of college, in terms of NYC, New York City, in terms of, are you happy with the evolution of Adam Goldberg from season 1 to 10, or had you other ideas in your own sort of head of where he might have finished up?
Well, honestly, like looking at the character as the character from season 1, I think he would have been like, all right, because I don't think he ever would have guessed him having as many girlfriends as he had, and like that they were all just like the most spectacular relationships. So And it does seem kind of fitting after the first episode, getting the help from Pops and everything. And then this whole last season, it's kind of like him kind of feeling more confident in that realm. And I think it's weird. Sometimes I would feel kind of like how the character was feeling, because in the final season, he was kind of wanting to pump the brakes on. Well, how many episodes have aired in Ireland? Has it started yet?
Season 10, Channel E4. Yes, it's out. Very prominent, the Goldbergs. No sooner is it out in America than a month or two afterward, it hits Ireland and the UK here as well. So, yeah, it's been... The turnaround has been very sort of fast in terms of from when it's aired in the US to when it's aired here in Ireland and the UK to pick up. E4 has constantly picked it up throughout the years here in Ireland.
That's great. Yeah, I was worried about saying a spoiler or something like that, because I remember on social media I saw that I can't remember where it was being aired. I was like, oh, so that just happened. And I was like, don't want to... But that's cool. That does sound like a fast turnaround.
Yeah. And Sean, in terms of the Goldbergs, it's been such a big part of your life. It's been your childhood, and obviously it's brought so much attention to you. It's brought so much publicity. You're probably known all across the United States as Adam Goldberg. Now that adventure has sort of closed its doors, and once it's never really closed its doors, are you sort of bit saying, well, I'm waking up now in the morning, the Goldbergs are no longer, I'm not going to set like I did for the last 10 years. Do you almost feel like, well, what's the next journey going to be now for Sean rather than Sean and Adam? Because Sean and Adam were always sort of linked, dare I say, hip by hip. You're always a tandem duo. You went together. That's the whole America, the whole audience world, seeing you grow up as these sort of two characters intertwined. That cycle has come to an end now. And how excited are you for the next chapter in the acting career of Sean Giambrone?
Well, I'm very excited. That's an interesting idea. Yeah, but I'm excited. It was kind of interesting that each year of my life I kind of had photographs from, so I saw myself grow. So now there's going to be like potentially there could be a gap between, and I'm looking forward to just trying to figure out different acting techniques and things, and it's weird. When I got the last script and everything, I was like, wow, I was getting sentimental to like the names that I like, or like the common, like I wouldn't be saying like, oh balls, and I won't be yelling at Barry and Erica. Like, it was kind of hitting me, some of those kind of things. And but yeah, I'm definitely feeling a little restless. So I joined a soccer league, I joined a softball league, and so I'm just moving around. But now, yeah, I'm gonna focus up on acting, and we'll see what happens. Maybe I'll do. I guess who knows what? I guess I'll just be ready for it.
And Sean, you've been involved in sort of so much the comedy aspect for the last 10 years or so. Have you a real affection towards that genre, or as an actor, or you think to yourself, I'm open to take on now more exciting roles, action roles, horror roles, different sorts of genres, exposing myself to the different types of that comes with an actor? You've experienced comedy now for the last 10 years of your life. Are you excited to experience maybe an odd movie production where you're playing maybe a bad guy, maybe you're playing in an action sort of a thriller, maybe a sort of suspense movie? Is that excite you to break away from the comedy norm, or do you think that you're so rooted in that sort of genre that you'll feel so comfortable in that genre, that's the genre you like to stick to, or are you open to all sorts of challenges?
I think what originally got me into acting and stuff is I kind of just like to entertain, like I like to goof around, and so I really like that aspect of but then doing Goldbergs, I always like the heart that was put on the show. And so I think that's what kind of drew me to that. So I think I'll always want to come back to some sort of comedy at some point, because it's just a lot of fun and everyone on the crew's hopping in and throwing jokes. But my dad always says, like, you got to put yourself in some uncomfortable situations or whatever to grow sometimes, to try new things and challenges. So that's definitely a part of my, if the challenges are doing like action movies or horror movies or horror shows, some of the shows sometimes seem creepier sometimes, but yeah, I'll definitely give it a whack or whatever, give it a go.
Yeah. And Sean, for the first time in your life, you've a bit of free time, a bit of downtime in terms of maybe getting to see the world, getting to see sort of places. And before we came on air, you mentioned you were close in the past to coming to the Emerald Isle in terms of Ireland. Is that on the book of this? Obviously, you have a bit more, tiny bit more time in your hand. I still know you're a busy man, but you can make some of those long-awaited plans come a reality in terms of 2023, in terms of getting out and seeing the big bad world.
Yeah, it hasn't been. I enjoy traveling so much, and I was supposed to come for there was a Northwestern Nebraska college football game, and my best friend from preschool, him and his whole family went, and it just happened that the Goldbergs started right that week, so I couldn't make it. But yeah, I'm definitely have to get over to Ireland, because it just sounds like one of the most beautiful places. And I haven't made it a priority to travel, but I really should start venturing out more and seeing some stuff.
And Sean Giambrone, the final sort of the second last question before I leave you there today. In terms of, let's pretend Goldbergs had an encyclopedia, a sort of dictionary as such, and they put all the characters in this sort of encyclopedia. And obviously, first up, Adam Goldberg, they left two blank sentences under his name, sort of not an epitaph, but a synopsis as such, and they came to you, Sean Giambrone, and they asked you to write those two sentences to describe Adam Goldberg. What would you like those two sentences to read?
It would be that's a great question. I think it would be a fun-loving the youngest brother who loves family and anything potentially nerdy. Oh, crud. I wanted to make it sound poetic, but that doesn't come easy to me. But yeah, I guess a nerdy kid that, with the help of his family, grows up to become more confident, and then ends up living his dream of writing TV and movies. And he has a GoBot collection. That's what
I put. And Sean Giambrone, finally, before I let you go, the Goldbergs, when you look back at this chapter in your life in 10, 20 years' time, in terms of what the Goldberg, obviously, has probably set you on a platform here at stardom at the moment. No doubt there's many more chapters to be told in the career of Sean Giambrone. But when you look back in the Goldbergs in particular, will you say, yeah, that was a period of my life that I would do over again in a heartbeat?
Absolutely. I would, yes. That's a big yes.
Yeah. On that note, Sean Giambrone, for me, Jim Conlan, a pleasure talking to you on the airwaves this evening. To promote season 10 of The Goldbergs, do catch it out. Don't miss it, because it won't be there again in terms of season 10. But it will be on replays, but you won't get to see it live anyway. That's for sure. And no doubt, Sean Giambrone, Adam Goldberg, what a story, what a chapter. 10 seasons in total. When we think about the A-Team, Married with Children, Cheers, all those iconic TV series, Seinfeld, Frasier, all those comedy series throughout the decades that got past that magical six mark. No, all throughout the decades, seasons, TV series would finish up around the six. Very hard to go past that. The Goldbergs ventured on for 10 seasons. That makes it a classic, a cult classic TV series. Sean Giambrone, you were very much part of that, playing the iconic character Adam Goldberg. A pleasure for me, Jim Conlan, talk to you on airwaves this evening. Do stay active. And Sean, do visit Ireland in the near future. We welcome you with open arms.
Well, I so appreciate that. Jim, it was awesome and wonderful talking with you. Thanks for having me.
Cheers, Sean.